I'd like to start with a quote of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. He says, "I like the religion that teaches liberty, equality, and fraternity." Today, we are in a position throughout the world where religions are far moving away from teaching us liberty, equality, and fraternity. Yesterday, what happened here was deplorable, and it was condemned by everybody, and the leader of the house condemned it. Mehenji was insulted. Our leader, Dr. Kalangar, today has condemned what has happened. He has said that she has worked in the path of Baba Saheb Ambedkar and Kanshi Ramji, and that is why they have actually targeted her and insulted her. Actually, it is something she should be proud of. If she has been targeted because she is following the footsteps of Baba Saheb Ambedkar and Kanshi Ram, and people are trying to threaten her because of that, because she is working for the upliftment of people who have been suppressed for centuries, she should be proud of it, and we are standing one with her to continue her great work. And this thing of trying to insult women, character assassination, has been used as a weapon against women in public life, and this has to stop. So, we've been talking about what happened in Gujarat, about the youth who were insulted, flogged, beaten up, insulted. And this did not happen just for a few minutes. It happened for hours together. They were actually dragged on the streets. There were so many people standing there as mute spectators, watching it, egging the people on. And where were the authorities? Where were the police? Where were the people who had to keep the law, who had to take action on these people who were insulting these Dalits? Where were they? They were nowhere. For hours together, this happened. But why is it nobody called the police authorities? And why didn't they come? And I'd like to ask, who are these self-proclaimed cow protectors? Everybody who spoke here said that, is it a crime? It was not a crime, actually, to skin this, remove the carcass and remove the skin. Even if it was a crime, just looking at a cow was a crime, even touching it if it was a crime. Who are these people? Who are these self-proclaimed protectors to take law into their hands? Why aren't we banning organizations like this? We ban books, we ban writers from writing. So many writers have even given up writing. In Tamil Nadu it happened. There's a writer who said, "I will not write anymore. I'm dead." But why aren't we saying anything against organizations like this, who take law into their hands? So, I'd like to quote an incident which happened in a lot of people here who spoke about converts. When a Dalit converts into Christianity or Islam, the society does not change. Society still looks at them as Dalits. They do not say, "Okay, you've converted, now I treat you as equally." It doesn't solve anything. So that is why our leader, Dr. Kalangar, has time and again written and has insisted that the Dalits who convert also have to be given reservations, and they also have to be protected. This incident actually will bring to make you understand. In Tirunelveli, a 60-year-old Dalit woman was raped. The police were, more than filing the FIR, they were more keen on saying that she was not a Dalit, because they can avoid a few sections. That is the intention. They were not interested in finding out what happened, in enforcing law.
That is not intention. That is law.
No. One minute.
Please be seated.
No, let me finish, sir.
Please be seated.
No, I am not talking about you. I am talking about what
please
happened.
Please be seated. When your turn comes, you please speak. Yes, Kanimozhi, continue.
Sir, they were more interested in saying that she was not a Dalit. She finally, after the collector over there intervened. It was found out that she was a Dalit woman, a Hindu Dalit. So, this is how law has been used against the Dalits. We've been time and again, and the society hasn't changed. If society, just be, if the Dalits are educated, if they've gone up in status, is the world looking at them differently? No. It's a case of Rohit Venmala. So, according to NCRB, in 2014, out of 1,27,341 cases which went for trial for the atrocities against Dalits, only 5,103 were convicted. Out of 1,27,000, only 5,000 were convicted. So the Dalits are economically depressed. They depend on upper caste Hindus for their survival, for their livelihood. This has to change. We cannot talk about growth, which is not inclusive. Has development reached them? Has development been inclusive of the Dalits in this country? No. We're talking about reservation. We say the seats which are given, allotted for the Dalits, are not filled in many institutions. There is a school headmaster of a state who says, for 42 years we've made sure that no Dalit student has entered our school in India. A headmaster proudly says, we've made sure that 42 years no Dalit student has entered our school. How do these students get a chance for education? How do they enter colleges? How do they get justice?
So,
sir,
please
in
conclude.
Anganwadis, there are different plates.
You have made
Dalit children.
Okay.
Sir, please, there are in Anganwadis where the children go, there are different plates for the Dalit students and upper caste Hindus. How can a child ever forget this scar? Can it ever any child forget this scar for its entire life? How will a student, a child who is bearing this burden, this cross, ever be considered equal in the society? How can they ever forgive us? Sir, in Tamil Nadu, in schools, children come with different colored threads in their hand. One minute, this is not against the state government.
Please sit down.
This is not.
Please sit down. No controversy, please. Please sit down. She is not yielding. Please sit down.
Sir, okay, not Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu doesn't have caste.
If anything is to oppose,
Tamil Nadu
you have
caste.
You are getting chance to.
Yes.
Take the chair.
So there are students who come with different colored bands to indicate which community.
Oh.
I am talking about the society, sir. He was there when this incident happened in Tamil Nadu, and he has commented upon it, how it was very unfortunate that a 100-year-old man was not given a decent burial. He was there, it happened in Nagapattinam district. So this person, in your Mayiladuthurai, he was a man who was 100 years old. He died. 2016,
so,
sir. In 2016, yes. And his grandson moved the high court because the common pathway, he knew that they will not be allowed to go to the burial ground. The grandson knew that. I'm not saying it's happening in Tamil Nadu alone. It's happening in many places. It's happening everywhere. Even the cremation grounds there is discrimination there. You can't be buried, you can't be burnt without discrimination and caste.
So please conclude.
No, sir,
sit down.
They interrupted, sir. Why did you let them interrupt?
Everybody sit down. I'm not allowing anybody. I am asking Kanimozhi to complete in one sentence, please.
Sir, I have let me finish because they were interrupting. I was not allowed to speak.
You speak your way.
Yes, I am not talking to them. I am addressing. I am talking to you.
Yes, directly. No.
Sir, I've been interrupting
so many
times. Sir, he moved the high court and got a favorable order that there is no legal bar to use the common pathway and to undertake the funeral procession. The government officials, after that, invited the Dalits and the caste Hindus and held talks. However, the caste Hindus refused to accept the HC order and reiterated that they will not allow the Dalits to carry the dead body through the common pathway. The officials, instead of implementing the High Court order, took a stance to appease the caste Hindus by creating a new pathway. The common path, the High Court has given an order, but the officials... So the High Court
She is concluding now.
Sir. And finally, Dalits were not allowed. The Dalits were not allowed to take the body through the common pathway, and the police carried it to the burial ground, the cremation ground.
Please.
The police carried it to the cremation ground.
No, I am not allowing anybody. Not allowing anybody. Yes.
Sir,
I've asked her to sit down. Yes.
Sir, let me conclude. Please. How insensitive officials can be, how insensitive law implementing authorities can be. Like somebody here mentioned earlier also, that unless we sensitize these authorities, unless we sensitize judiciary, unless we sensitize police force, unless we sensitize politicians, unless we sensitize society, never can this caste system and untouchability be eradicated. And I'd like to finish with another quote of Baba Saheb Ambedkar. Despotism does not cease to be despotism because it is effective. Nor does despotism become agreeable because despots belong to our own kindred. Thank you.
मुझे लगता है कि राहुल गांधी जी गए अच्छी बात है जाए वो जाए वापिस आए वो तो मतलब आप लोग तो मतलब मुझे तो आपने बहुत बार दिया था धोखा लेकिन नरेंद्र मोदी ने दे दिया मुझे मंत्री पद का मौका